but you don't feel it now. And I declare you won't ever feel it again. If it tries to come back, you say, no, I'm healed in Jesus' name. There you go. Father, there are those here today, obviously, that are needing specific direction. Not assignments, but specific direction. I thank you that your word says in Romans 8, they that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. Holy Ghost, lead and guide and direct this sheep. Anytime he tells you something, write it down. It shows you honor what he is saying to you. You may say, well, I'll never forget it. That doesn't matter. The word also says that we're going to write the vision down and make it plain so that we will run with it. If he says to you as simple as, I want you to call so-and-so tomorrow morning, write it down. If he gives you a nugget of revelation, write it down. We were in a service here in Tulsa several years back. But you know what they say about Tulsa? We can teach it, but we can't perform it. You know what they say about Tulsa? It's Tulsa-Rusalem, the religious mecca of the world. But that's changing because I believe with all of my heart that the things that God has already done is going to start manifesting through people just like you and I. I believe God will even use white people. Seriously. You got a call on your life. I laid hands on you and I felt the fire of God. Just one step at a time. Baby steps, as they call it. One step at a time. My goodness. Think about the times you have talked about the Lord and how powerful it rose up on the inside of you and how powerful the result was. God's called you to be a mighty evangelist. Get ready. Run with it. You're supposed to be frustrated right now because this is what God has you to do, ultimately. The frustration that you're dealing with right now is a good indicator and a good sign that you got to where you were supposed to be, but you're not supposed to stay here. And I'm talking about the line of business. Business. Promotion's coming to you very quickly. Pray out in the Holy Spirit. It's coming to you very quickly. Hallelujah. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Glory. I don't sit there and beg God, oh God, it is your will. If you can find it in your heart to heal this young man, now, how did I pray for you? We just did it. Just said it. So we need to know when to stay and when to pray. Too many times we've been praying when we should be saying. Does that make sense? Jesus went up into the mountain apart to pray, so that when he came down off the mountain and the multitudes met him, he had authority to say.
Telling every
everybody in my business looked, but we couldn't understand anything that was being said because it was all in tongues. For like about a minute, and then she just fell out. Probably out of embarrassment and the anointing. But she gets up off the floor instead of going, "Wow, I've heard from God." She comes and sits down and goes, "I cannot believe you just did that in front of everybody." I said, "Did what?" "Mom, that was a blessing. You got to pray for that. That's a blessing." "No, that he told all my business in front of everybody like that." She had heard in English, and yet it's on a CD and he spoke it in tongues. Divers tongues. Crazy stuff. She went back and listened to it. She goes, that's impossible. Because he was saying stuff that only God could have known. And I'm thinking, why would God tell him that to tell everybody listening? Isn't God good though? He didn't spill her mess on everybody. He just prayed it out, said it, spoke it, prophetically said what he needed to say. She heard in English. And after that, she was set free. Up until then, she was mad. Glory to God. So I believe with all my heart, you got direction today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, slip our hands again. You can't praise this God too much. I don't know if you know that or not. That's why we say we can't stop praising this name. We just can't stop.
Yes. Yes.
Think about the time, like even this morning, when you hit that river, that flow, when you just thought, man, I don't ever want to be anywhere else. I just want to keep praising him like this. I just can't stop. That is how God is every single moment, every single day, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The way he is with loving us, with blessing us, with protecting us, and he never gets out of that flow. Oh, thank you, Lord. You can't outpraise God. You can't outgive God. You can't outbless God. Oh, thank you, Lord. You don't always have to break open the Bible for word to be flowing, but then somewhere down the line, it's the Holy Ghost that gives confirmation to the word. So we have to allow confirmation of that word. Otherwise, we're not a balanced church. Balance never meant dry. Dry is out of balance. Goofy is out of balance. But balance is balanced during the song. I know this sounds funny, but this is going on the internet. Stretch your hands towards the camera. We're going to pray for every single person that watches this particular episode or broadcast. We pray right now in the name of Jesus, no matter what you're dealing with, whatever pain, sickness, or disease that you're dealing with, be set free right now in the name of Jesus. If you're in a wheelchair, get up. If you've got crutches, throw them down. If you've got blind eyes, see. If you're listening with a deaf ear, I command that ear to open and hear for the first time in Jesus' name. Yes, we thank you, Lord, for it. Cancer, go. Be burned out of those bodies. Tumors, fall off. Disappear in the name of Jesus. Marriages, come back together. Marriages, reunite in Jesus' name. A fire coming back, a passion coming back. We thank you, Lord, for those watching. A hunger being stirred. A hunger to know you more. A hunger to read the word. A hunger to pray and to worship greater than before. In Jesus' name. Oh, we thank you, Lord, for this. Speaking to us, giving us direction. We were telling you, too, that God's opening the doors for us to go on television. Now, we don't want to go on TV just because. If we've got something, then we want to give it. We don't want to just go on TV to be lost in the mix with a bunch of people that really are just performers. We really want the Holy Ghost shooting through those airwaves and messing with people's homes in a good way. I mean, coming in and wrecking stuff. Come on, you know what I mean? You know, that kind of like, you know, you better check yourself before the Holy Ghost wrecks yourself. You know what I mean? That's the kind of stuff. I want to see God moving and people writing in and saying, I got up out of my wheelchair. I was praising God. My shoulder popped. My arches were healed. I was dancing around my room. We couldn't have children. You prayed, and all of a sudden we can have children. We are so blessed we're going to name our child Jay. But listen, what's begun here, don't let it go out. I won't, because no matter where I go, I'm not going to let it go out. So wherever you go, that's your assignment. Extra 10 minutes of speaking in tongues. Extra 10 minutes of worshiping God. Extra 10 minutes here and there of reading the Word. Come on, each day, not every now and then. Don't wait for Sunday. Sunday doesn't count. That's like coming to take your test and going to study. Ain't that right, Hunter? All right. I can tell which one of y'all did that too, because all these men over here are grinning and looking back like they got your back. All right. There, the stumble's coming back. That growth is there, baby. Hallelujah. Come on, let's welcome Dr. Hill back to the platform.
All right. Yes, sir. All right, we've been tremendously blessed this week. It's been a great week, and we are going to continue on tomorrow night. Tomorrow night, we'll be here at 7. Amen. How many going to get in the flow? We believe the flow is on. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
And Wednesday night, Brother Jay is going to fit us into the schedule once again. And Friday morning at 5 o'clock. Everybody said 5 o'clock. Friday morning. All right, turn around and tell. Ask somebody, you hear that? Continuously set the stage for God to do more. Alright, so we're going to expect you back tomorrow night. Wednesday night. Everybody just say Wednesday night. Don't miss it, don't miss it. Don't miss it, don't miss it. Wednesday night, glory. We're just going to be rejoicing, praising God, and praising Him, amen, for the miracles that He has already performed. Amen. He's going to be good. All right. Let me see what else I need to say.